it's Peter Spencer.
I'm here about selling the house.
Is anyone home?
This is Detective Muldoon.
This is Peter Spencer. Something happened to me at 44 Rayburn Drive.
Someone was murdered at the house.
Why did you never go into that place?
Something never felt right about it.
Looks like we got another one.
Do you think that the body we found's related? Hello? I went to the house. Hello? Police department. I think something followed me home.
Mommy, what's going on? What's wrong?
We need to leave right now.
As the attorney representing Adrian's trust, I'm required to read a prepared statement. Cecilia, although our relationship was far from perfect, I thought that you would talk to me rather than run away.
Are you okay?
I would not die!
What happened to him?
He cut his wrists. Per his final wishes, you're getting $5 million. Contingent, of course, on the fine print.
He can't be ruled to be mentally incompetent.
It just doesn't make any sense.
What?
Adrian wouldn't kill himself.
Listen, you're getting your freedom back, okay? Don't let him haunt you.
Hello? I'm scared.
You don't have to be scared of him anymore.
He was a sociopath, completely in control of everything. He said that wherever I went, he would find me, walk right up to me, and I wouldn't be able to see him.
Are you okay?
Someone sitting in that chair. I found something that can prove what I'm experiencing.
You need help.
Adrian is dead. I went to his house today.
He's not dead.
I have a pile of ashes in the box that would disagree with you.
He has figured out a way to be invisible.
Only thing more brilliant than inventing something that makes you invisible is coming up with the perfect way to torture you, even in death. Adrian's true genius was how he got in people's heads.
Don't come any closer. Hey!
I'm not crazy. Please listen to me.
You're saying the person trying to kill you is in the room right now, but we can't see him?
He's listening. Where are you?
Where are you? Show yourself! Come on! Do it!
There you are.
There is an elevator. In the elevator, you press the button to the floor with no name. Behind those doors, there's a life you always dreamt of.
The plane, it's here. This weekend, you will be our guests.
Here, anything and everything is possible.
No service. It's not everything is possible.
Good evening. I'm Mr. Rurik. Let me officially welcome you to Fantasy Island.
Fantasy Island!
I'm curious how this all works.
What if your fantasy involves a person from your life?
Holograms, like Tupac.
What if it's somebody who died?
Tupac.
So, what's your fantasy?
Revenge on a childhood bully.
Your life is about to change. I hope you're ready.
That is a really good hologram.
There is only one fantasy per guest. And you must see your fantasy through.
It brought her back to life.
No matter what.
Oh my God, that's really her.
Rourke, this is not what I meant.
What the hell is this place?
People die here.
The island's twisting what we asked for.
We weren't brought here to have our own fantasies.
I want it, I got it, I want it.
We were brought here to be a part of someone else.
I got it, I want it, I got it.
I'm your friend.
I've always wanted to hear you say that.
Have you ever been a nanny?
This is my first live-in job.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing. The children are very special, Kate. They're thoroughbreds.
Geez, your friends must love it here.
I have no friends.
You have no friends?
Yep.
Well, you have one now.
Maybe.
May I ask how the parents died?
Aww.
Miles!
Nothing should have to suffer.
It's not that simple.
I don't go in that part of the house.
Why not?
Don't wanna.
Hello?
Shouldn't be in here.
What happened to your last nanny?
Like I'd tell.
You need to take charge here, Kate.
I know what you're afraid of. Keeping the lights on won't keep you safe.
Can you please stop?
You're gonna leave me, aren't you?
I'm not going anywhere.
Promise, promise?
Cross my heart and hope to die.
Everyone dies, Miles.
Did you see them? I don't want to play anymore. Hey! Why are you doing this?
Stop now.
We're not safe!
Stop giving tales.
Bad dreams?
fairy tale has a way of getting into your head, even before you hear it. Somehow you just know it. And it always went like this.
Pleased to make your acquaintance. I'm called Gretel, and this rough one here is my brother Hansel.
Ouch! Tell me how you came to be in my woods.
There's too much, and it isn't right.
You're scared.
There's something wrong here.
Careful, dear. I'd hate for you to start something you can't stop.
Look at this.
All those years in the big city, we finally got out. We're living the dream.
Maybe.
Then everything just blew up. Big flash, like a pink light. Or actually, I don't even know what color it was. It wasn't like any color I'd ever seen before. It
looks like a meteorite.
Is this radioactive? I mean, it's from space, right?
Meteorites are generally no more dangerous than ordinary rocks.
How can something that big just disappear? Did you plant those?
No.
Ward, you come here for a sec.
Oh, God.
What are you doing?
Shh. It's talking to me.
Who's talking to you?
It's in the static, it's in the moisture. It's in here, is out there. And what's out there is in here now.
Everything's under control.
Why are you so in denial? That ding from the meteorite changes everything around it.
It's just the color. No! But it burns.
Can you believe me now?
I don't know what I believe anymore. Everything's gonna be A-okay.
Having to be a girlfriend. I mean, don't you think so?
How would I know? I can't seem to get a boyfriend.
Yeah, what if you just put yourself out there?
Oh, he's cute. Can I talk to him?
Give it to me.
Oh, so you have a secret admirer.
No, I don't.
Hello?
So now you're ready to go on a date?
I think so. I mean, I know we haven't seen each other in person, but I feel like we know more about each other than people who meet normally.
I have an idea. Halloween, this is Friday. I saw an ad for a warehouse party.
Okay, what would I go as?
How about a zombie cheerleader? You are the most beautiful dead girl I've ever seen.
Thank you.
Good morning, Sadie.
Brad, you know my name is Chelsea.
Your name is Sadie, now.
Who are you?
I'm Sadie.
I'm stopping us from getting into trouble.
What's your name?
Sadie.
Your real name?
It's Sadie.
Good girl.
You need to bleach your hair now.
What? Why?
Because Brad says so. Everything is because Brad says so.
Something wrong, Sadie? You can tell me.
I miss my mom.
This is your new family.
Does anyone even try to find a way out?
Don't talk about that. We have to work together. It's our only chance.
No, we don't.
I'm not your sister, Sadie!
He's planning to kill you. Today.
You just tried to turn me against him.